Hey guys, I'm Elise and you're watching the IFLS show, which this week is brought to you by Audible. So unless you were living under a rock last week, you probably heard about the major event, a blood moon eclipse. If you missed it, never fear, NASA released this gorgeous time lapse of the entire event. I'll link the whole video in the information section. Dashboard cameras in Russia also captured a suspected meteorite explosion this week. It's possible that the object is part of the annual Lyrid meteor shower, which peaks on Tuesday. There were no reports of any emergency services being called, but it put on quite a show, as you can see. Big news in astronomy this week, we may actually have witnessed the birth of a new moon. Meet Peggy, Saturn's newest satellite. Exactly 1 year ago, a narrow-angle camera on board NASA's Cassini spacecraft accidentally recorded disturbances at the very edge of Saturn's A ring, the outermost of the rings. One of these disturbances is an arc, about 1,200 kilometers long and 10 kilometers wide, that was about 20% brighter than its surroundings. There's also evidence of unusual protuberances in the usually smooth profile at the ring's edge. Researchers believe the arc and protuberances are caused by the gravitational effects of a nearby object. The icy object is probably no more than a kilometer in diameter, making it way too small to be seen in images right now. What researchers have observed, and what I've just shown you, is evidence of commotion at the ring's edge, believed to be caused by Peggy's presence. This week in biology, scientists discovered an entirely new type of sexual organ. In a cave in Brazil, an insect has been discovered that has swapped genitals. This new genus has been dubbed Neotrogla, and the insects themselves are about 1 millimeter long and kind of look like flies. In this species, the female has a previously unheard of sexual organ which has been named a gynosome. When it's time to mate, the female mounts the male, inserts her gynosome into his vagina-like genitalia, and they begin a copulation session that lasts 40 to 70 hours. After it's been inserted, the gynosome curves inside of the male, locking the two together. The connection is so strong that a researcher who tried to pull the two apart during the deed accidentally ripped the male's body in half, but still didn't manage to separate their genitals. SpaceX successfully launched their Falcon 9 rocket carrying the Dragon spacecraft last week. It connected with the International Space Station early on Sunday morning and delivered supplies like repairs, food, new cameras, a vegetable garden prototype, and a new communication system. This is the third of 12 scheduled cargo deliveries that NASA has contracted SpaceX to do. The next cargo launch is scheduled for June 6th. And finally, the huge news this week, NASA's Kepler team announced the discovery of an Earth-sized planet in its star's habitable zone. Kepler-186f is about 10% larger than Earth and orbits an M-type dwarf star around 500 light-years away in the constellation Cygnus. The star is about half the size and mass of our Sun, and it takes Kepler-186f about 130 Earth days to complete a revolution. It's on the outer edge of the star's habitable zone, so the planet receives about a third of the radiation from its parent star as we do from ours. We only know of one planet that has life, Earth. So when we're looking for signs of life elsewhere in the universe, we focus on looking for planets that resemble Earth. And this is the closest we've ever found. So as I mentioned at the start of this episode, this week the IFLS show is brought to you by the nice people over at Audible. Now what this means for you guys is if you go to www.audible.com/IFLS, you can download a free audiobook of your choice. They've got 150,000 titles to choose from, but more importantly for you, they have a fantastic science section. This week I'm recommending my favourite science book of all time, Richard Dawkins' The Ancestor's Tale. It tracks the history of life and our ancestors over the last several billion years, and it is a book that blows my mind every time I read it, so I thoroughly recommend it. That's it from me this week, guys. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to tune in next week, and don't forget to subscribe.